Okay, dyan sa envelope nyo, pakilabas nyo yung handout na nakalagay, Jibro Congress. Jibro Congress. O yung iba sa inyo na gusto makakuha ng PowerPoint ni Hill, o mamayang break, bigay nyo sa kanya ang ano nyo, USB nyo. Or pinut together ng Ben? Well, hindi pa. Nasa yun yung kay Hill, wala pa. Okay. So either pumunta kay Pastor Hill or kay Rolly. Meron sila mga kopya nun. Okay, I trust binasa nyo na yan, yung material na yan, Congress. And sa bandang huli yun, nakalagay Jibro Congress. Mga 3 pages yan with details. Okay, meron tayong video clip to promote yung Congress yan. Gusto kong tingnan nyo ito para alam nyo kung anong gagawin nyo. Should you decide to be a part of that Congress next year? Okay? Sige, roll.
Pastor leaders are present in their communities. They are long-term, they are less expensive, they're on-site, they are more relevant. A pastor is the best strategic leader to reach into a community. God has called and gifted and placed 2 million plus pastors. The lower estimates are 2.2 million pastors. Upper estimates of 3.4 million pastors. This is an amazing work of God. In a fast-paced growth, pastors who do not know how to lead and live biblically will not think and then preach biblically. They don't know how to preach biblically. So endemic to the growth of the vast number of pastors is a deficit of training. Because pastoral health affects church health, and church health affects societal health. In 2016, in Bangkok, Thailand, we'll bring up to 5,000 pastoral trainers ministering in 200 countries. Over those 8 days, we have 4 objectives for the Jibro Congress. One is to build community between formal and non-formal pastoral trainers. Secondly, is to explore opportunity. There are vast numbers of pastors who have not yet been trained. We also will discover resources, human resources, which are the central asset. Second would be curricular resources. Third, technology resources. And how do we deliver technology-based pastoral training? Of course, there's financial resources that are needed. The least measurable of all the objectives is to exchange, to give and receive encouragement. Maybe the most important. The whole program is built around the 4 objectives. We're trusting the Lord to accomplish and implement these. But the most important part of this whole project is what's going to follow. We have a saying at Reach that every event begins the day after. From June 2016 to December 2020, we are asking and expecting reports from every pastoral trainer to commit to training 25 pastors a year on average for the following 4 years, for 100 pastors over 4 years. So not only better pastoral training, but more pastors trained. Throughout scripture, you can do a lot of things after you pray, but not without having prayed or before you pray. So would you join me in praying for total protection and global provision as we make prayer and praise the beginning and the end of this whole pastoral training initiative, and we'll let the impact be God's. I'm grateful that God has given us this vision, and people are joining us from across the body of Christ all over the world, because pastors in their countries, in their cities, in their communities are long-term, they're on-site, they're more relevant and less expensive. We think this is the best investment and return on investment for huge dividends, both humanly speaking and eternally speaking, for the cause of Christ. These are the boots on the ground for the 1 billion people, individuals, who will be exposed to the gospel as a result of this large initiative, the Global Proclamation Congress for Pastoral Trainers.
Again, you know, as Ramesh has asked us to pray for this Congress and then consider, you know, how the Lord may lead you. Here are instructions on how you can apply. The person you need to contact. Lalagay nga natin kay Nixon. Si ang national coordinator dito sa atin, pangalan niya is si Reverend or Pastor Nixon E. Chavez, Senior Pastor ng Fairview Christian Fellowship. Siya ang National Facilitator ng Congress. Yun ang email address niya, yun ang mobile number niya. Pag nag-apply kayo, kasi online application ito, ang nakalagay doon is yung National Recruiter's Passcode. So yun ang, ang code natin. 1523. Pakibalik mo lang rolet. Ah, yun pala, yun. Hindi, yung isa na. Okay na yan. Kalagay, apply online, yun o. And input passcode 1523. So pag na-approve ang email nyo, then that's the time to pay. So mayroong instruction yan. Pag binuksan nyo yung pag nag-apply kayo, meron nakalagay doon on how you are going to pay. May instruction doon. And then, eto, sulat nyo na to para alam nyo kasi merong time frame yung pag-apply ng application. Pag hindi nyo natapos yun, mawawala lahat ang sinulat nyo. Kaya kailangan meron na kayong data. So, ang unang tandaan nyo is, paliban doon sa passcode na yun, 1523, susulat nyo yun. One would be, of course, yung name nyo. I think naroon yung kung email address nyo, church nyo, or organization nyo. Kailangan alam nyo yun. And then may nakalagay doon, character reference. Sino nakakakilala sa inyo? So one, you can put my name. Sulat nyo yung pangalan ko. Or two, kung meron kayong sa denomination nyo, yung president nyo, or yung bishop nyo, sulat nyo yung pangalan nyo. This would be, kasi kukontakin nila yon. And then, merong section doon na nakasulat, sino ang pwede nyong i-recommend? So, it's either mag-recommend kayo ng mga pastor trainers na kilala nyo personally. At least dalawa yata. Dalawa ba? Okay. Kaya si Boom, naka-apply na yun. Na-approve na ba sa'yo? Hindi pa. Naghihintay ka pa. O siya, tapos na siya. Magbabayad na lang siya. Ako rin nag-apply na. Hindi pa rin ako. Wala pa ako natatanggap. Baring may natanggap na ako, hindi pa na ako nagbubukas ng email eh. Magkano yung registration fee? Tanda mo? Okay. Pag nag-register tayo, merong pre-registration fee. And ngayon medyo binaba na nila. Pag nag-pre-registration before this year ends, mga about 450. Yun yun. And then, kasi, pag let's say sa grupo nyo, let's say itong mga narito sa Aklan, nag-apply kayo, and you apply as a group, discounted yon. $450, so. Ano lang yun, ha? Board and lodging lang yon. And of course, materials. Wala pa, and food. Wala pa yung airfare nyo. So roughly, you'll have to trust God for $1,000. Airfare, registration, pocket money. Yun na yun. Now, sa ang venue is sa Bangkok. Walang visa sa Bangkok dahil member ng ASEAN yan. So, kailangan nyo lang is may passport kayo. Kaya kung wala pa kayong passport, trabahuin nyo na yon if you are planning to go. Okay? Any question? Yeah, sa June 16 to 15 to 22. So roughly 1 week yon. But siyempre, kailan pumunta kayo roon earlier? Or kukuha kayo ng morning flight. Most likely, mag-uumpisa yan, ano, lunch siguro. O kasama na yung hotel doon. Kasama na lahat yon. Sa registration, kasama na lahat yon. Yung hotel, food, etc. And then, ganun din, pag nakatanggap na kayo at na-approvehan kayo, isa sa mga itatanong niyan would be yung flight schedule nyo, anong oras kayo darating, and then if you need to be fetched sa airport, may sasalubong sa inyo. So, i-schedule nila yun, ha? Sila naman ang mag-a-approve niyan eh. But strictly speaking, tulad nyo sa narisahan out nyo, bali, limang categories eh, ang tatanggapin nila. And then, bawat category, merong quota, merong allocation ng number. One would be yung mga practitioners. Ibig sabihin, you are involved in pastoral training. So pag nakita nila yon, that's one consideration, one criteria. Two, if you are a strategist, hindi ka nagtitrain pero part ka ng isang team na kayo nag-strategize on how to do pastoral training. Ang tawag doon, strategist. Hindi ikaw necessarily ang nasa field, pero ikaw nag-iisip. Third is you are a tourist. And most likely ito yung mga nagtuturo sa mga seminary or Bible school, nagtuturo sila on how to train pastors. Ito yung ang alam nila narito sa utak. Yung practitioner, yung nasa field. So tayo basically mga practitioners tayo. And then funders. Hindi ka practitioner, hindi ka strategist, but you are part or you have a heart for pastoral training and you are funding. Kasi halimbawa sa topic, meron tayong a few who are our funders sa topic. Pwede silang imbitahin para alam nila kung ano sinusuportahan nila. So kung meron sa regions ninyo, meron kayong kilala na may heart for pastors and pastoral training, imbitahin nyo sila and lagay nila funder sila. Sinusuportahan. Sumusuportahan. Hindi, kanya-kanya na yung ticket. Oh, ito si Pastor Gina. Pastor Gina, meron siyang alam daw. Travel agency. Christian ito at inaayos niya yon. Kaya kung makakuha tayo ng group discount, yun yun. Oh. So, si Pastor Gina, dito siya sa Boracay. Oo, oh, yun nga. Lalo na pag nakahanda ng pera natin, the earlier natin makuha ang ticket, the better. And then yung lastly are aspirants. Ang aspirants, hindi sila funders, hindi sila strategists, hindi sila theorists, hindi sila practitioner, they are potential and emerging pastor trainers. Ito yung possibly na minementoran natin. And if you think na ito talaga hot na hot siya at may passion siya for pastor, i-recommend nyo siya, encourage nyo sinyo siyang umaten. Mag-apply din siya. Okay? So, yun ang five categories. Generally, ang preference, generally, would be 50 years old, pababa. Kaya yung mga aspirants should be nasa 30s. 30s, mid-30s, early 40s. Yan yung mga aspirants. Nakalagay yan dyan sa binigay ko sa inyo. Okay? Any question? Tungkol sa Congress. The only sabihin natin, outcome expected sa atin pag umatin tayo sa Congress, lahat ng atin is that you are committed to train 25 pastors for the next 5 years. Now, kung practitioner na tayo, hindi problema yan. Ginagawa na natin yun eh. Kanya yan? We've been conducting training. But yun ang minimum nila. 25 pastors na you train for the next 5 years. Yun lang yung hihingi nila. Okay. Kung meron kayong tanong, just email us and we will help you sa application.